In this video, I'm going to talk to you about your website and Instagram, obviously. There are a couple of things that you need to know. You need to have a website or you need to have an Etsy store. And you need to do this. Maybe not now, but it's something you need to be working on as we move through this course and as your business begins to grow. When you start having your Instagram account, it's great to just post and start to get people interested and engaged with your brand. One really great thing that you can do with your Instagram account if you don't have your website up and ready yet is you can begin promoting your website and getting people excited for the release. And then once that website releases, you're gonna have some really great data because everyone's coming to your website based on the following that you've created. So let's talk a little bit more about what kind of a website you need and the Etsy store that you might want. Something that you need to consider is whether you're a product or a service. If you are a product and something that's a little bit more handcrafted, like maybe some cool dream catchers or an artist, or like a little tiny book artist or something, Etsy stores might be the right choice for you. But if you're someone who has a very specialized product, like a new camera lens, then you need to make sure that you have a website, because you're really not gonna sell a camera lens on an Etsy store. It's just not how it works. Maybe Amazon, but even then, you wanna have a website to redirect people to when it comes to learning more about your product. And this is especially important if you have a product like a camera lens or a service, so that people can research a little bit more about your product or service. If you're a creator, I highly suggest centering your Instagram around your products and you taking people behind the scenes about your products so that you have some really great fun content that people can engage with if you don't have a website. On your Etsy store, it's going to be really important that you focus on customizing your Etsy store so that it looks more branded to you and not necessarily branded towards Etsy. Another thing that you need to consider when you're debating whether or not you want to have a website or an Etsy store are the number of people that are coming to your Etsy store. If you're having thousands and thousands of dollars of sales on your Etsy store, it's time to build a website so that you can begin growing that side of your business as well. And then you don't have to adhere to some of the limitations that an Etsy store might have. Your website will allow you to customize every bit and every aspect of everything to do with the sales process and the experience that you have created on Instagram that you're now putting on your website as well. Once you've been able to determine whether or not you need a website or an Etsy store or something else, then you can really begin to hone in on your Instagram and decide where you're going to have some of your links direct people to. There's also something else that you should consider. If you're a creator in a sense of a blogger, writer, podcaster, author, you wanna make sure that you're creating an Instagram account where you're able to guide people to view that content. There are certain character and content limits on Instagram that don't really allow you to exceed more than 10 minutes and more than 1,000 different characters within the post. So writing a blog on your Instagram is really not possible, especially if you're diving deep into a subject that really needs to be explained. So having a website where that blog can be hosted and where you can share a little bit about that blog on your Instagram profile is a great way to allow people to view more of your content on an expanded basis. If you're a podcaster, you're really focusing on people who you want to go to your iTunes account or people that you want to have subscribed to you on Spotify or any other kind of podcast network. And you can't do that without a website. Even if it's just a simple basic website, you need to make sure that you have all of the proper hosting set up and that you're able to make sure that you're tracking all of the data about people who are listening or people that are spending time on the page and reading a little bit more that you might have written about that podcast. Another thing that you need to consider, as we've talked about and mentioned several times throughout the course, is ensuring that all of the branding elements that you've created are both happening on your Instagram account, your website, and anywhere else that you might be marketing right now. If you have your Instagram account set up to be very aesthetically pleasing with really great, sexy filters, and then they get to your website and it's super crappy, that experience totally goes out the door. The trust is starting to go away. So you need to make sure that if you're going to build a website, that you actually build a high quality website. One of my favorite tools is using like something like showit.co, or you can use GoDaddy, WordPress, and there are tons of other different app and builders that you can place on your WordPress that allow you to really design something that looks great. And even if you're not a designer, places like showit.co have tons of really great free templates that you can use and customize so that you have a great website that isn't super highly designed or coded. And this is especially true if you are someone who is just not a designer, a developer, or anything. If you don't have the experience with building a website, using a website builder and learning how to use it is really, really simple. Another thing you need to consider with a website instead of using an Etsy store or some other kind of blog role is that you need to make sure that you have your website hosted. If it's not set up through a good host, your website could crash. Or if it's not set up through a good host, you just don't really have the bandwidth to handle the kind of traffic you might need or that you might be expecting. So making sure that you choose between the right host is really important. At the content below this video, you're going to see a ton of really great tools to help you build your website. These are tools that I have vetted out through different websites that I have built, as well as different hosting platforms I have experience with. And they're all based on different cost elements. So if you have a bigger budget for your website, there are some tools that you can use that are really expensive, but totally worth it. If you are more on a budget and you want to be able to build multiple websites and be able to fix and change and do some really custom things, some of the website builders through WordPress that I have are really great. My personal favorite is the Divi Builder. It's like taking building blocks from your toddler and building them on a website. It's so great and so easy to learn. I also have a few hosting channels that I really love. Bluehost is one of my favorite places to host my website, mainly because it's a lot simpler to go and pick and choose new URLs and add them onto my base site. GoDaddy is also a really great place and is by far the most popular one to use. So I highly suggest using GoDaddy as they are able to link to WordPress as well. That is it for talking about websites and Instagram and Etsy stores. If you're having a little bit of trouble deciding whether or not you want to start an Etsy store or keep on the Etsy store or have a website and begin blogging and doing some podcasting and everything, start a conversation in the Facebook group. Talk to other people, gauge their understanding of the whole world that you might be in, and also ask your Instagram followers. They will have a voice and opinion when it comes to where they want to buy products from you at. And if they're telling you to stick with an Etsy store, maybe you should. But if they're telling you they want more options than what you have available on your Etsy store, think about a website.